the cyber network was assembled together. I'm going to go through a few projects running. Using those, I'll be able to clarify share and then process division. Let's have a look at this piece first. What you see is planet Earth. Although the it is as close as resembling all the image I carry in my mind. Each of those points is the piece of information that represents some kind of event that happened in the present. All around the planet, humans interacting and accessing the network, sharing data, competing data, forging the history for the tomorrow and the next generation. What you see inside this orb is what is to be field of information. And the field of information is to visualize the time by scaling the fourth coordinate, which is uniform progression from 0 to 1 along data table walls, each of which would dictate an event that happened in the past. Each of those data table walls happened in this sequence of years. And that is exactly how virtual field of information is going to be assembled. Uniform progression and scaling of the whole system, of the whole planet, as we progress through the time trace is the logical way, and this is the way we're going to convert two-dimensional data table or Excel into the four-dimensional mechanism by using rows as the multiply of the whole, all by one. Then, navigating through it, we'll forge a search engine as an external observer, as well as forge the visual aid for presenting the tuition systems, therefore updating the global education facilities with the powerful visual assets, and concentrating on developing this library by connecting tag systems with the asset libraries. What we're able to achieve now is we're able not to be bound to the language, which means the field of information that we are going to construct whole events. Events, visual events that happened in the past. Those events have image and situation and what we have learned. Therefore, what we have learned and labeled is secondary. Therefore, the main thing is what we saw and what we then transcribed and passed on. Therefore, the image is the priority and the language is the secondary, which means that the system that we're going to create will be able to easily translate itself into any language nearly automatically. I am aware that there are certain pieces of code that have to be generated in order for this vision to be assembled, but initially Project Unreal Universe has turned to the system that would revolutionize the education institutions, and as well as byproduct of it would be generating uniform mechanism cyber space that would connect the network, the technology, and the scattered race of man. And that's why I learned Unreal Engine for the past year from the available sources. What you see is the core of the planet Earth. Let's say the boundary where the present is. Therefore, everything that lives above the shell of the Earth is the competitive marketing and social media posts and works of labors of the users. More detailed and organized structures shall be implemented, and the theoretical approach was already successful. Spectrum was harnessed and the color was able to define the procedure at which individual encounters and operates information, which was one of the crucial pieces, as it allows the spectrum to be used to connect the man and the nature. The nature and the technology. The spectrum that has its physical properties, as well as in us, its metaphysical properties, as well as its hierarchy, are going to be used to fracture the information, interact with it. What you see above the shell is the competitive data that is being fueled into the web. You see the people rise, people fall. There was no mortality agenda here, but the problem is that rating and ranks is the best. Therefore, section 3 and 4 are dedicated to defining the value. Green and fortify its weaknesses, measuring them against the ranks of the mutual products of similar class on any kind of encounter, that being green, yellow and green. Therefore, these two, they are able to provide the main key point at which all the information is going to be weighted, measured. What you see on the light traces, right where the shell is traces of light, which I symbolized the occurrence of the event right now. That can be a calamity, a national disaster, a nuclear warhead, or call for aid, assistance, advice, or any kind of situation that was pinged into the outer void for the cyber to reflect upon. Therefore, the previous point, you can see that the ranks are coming and falling, therefore they are competing. However, the pieces of information, the events, the key events, they're a bit bigger and a bit brighter. What happens to them is they are slowly sinking into the core where you see in the middle there are the black holes. Those black holes are beginning of such a junctions or threads in the evolution of the race of man. And each of those points would hold, for example, a science like biology, and then proceed tracing from there, which I have failed. Proceeding the trace would mean that starting from that point in history when humanity has uncovered certain science or technology, it will branch, spread, and target. The reason why is because in schooling institutions, it is exactly how children are learning, and therefore this is my priority to push the agenda unless anyone objects, and it proves to be inefficient. The thought form that the student must be formed and grow along the organism, meaning that current systems is not only two-dimensional, sinful of the old ways. The problem is not that. The problem is children has none of the any idea of connecting to the existing systems, since they are coming labelless to the point and did not see the past. Some of them, like me, was probably. But there are disadvantages. The point I'm making is that to construct field of information has only one point, the point of start. Where it is? From zero. Our bond to zero is the formation of our planet, and therefore we start building field of information with the point that science has agreed and traced till. Until the point where there's no more shell there. That is crucial because we're going to be labeling events as we grow. We're going to be moving and scaling this shell. Along this shell, while it will be scaled, all the events that happen that we have mastered, that we were able to witness, shall go into the past, and therefore the whole organism shall increase its scale. And that is exactly how we're going to access the quantum capacity of virtual technology. Nothing will change size, but the scale will change of the whole system. Therefore, we'll be able to access and convert the dimensional rows of data by tables into the four-dimensional simulation. That is useful for two occasions. That is useful to generate a four-dimensional search engine that would, right inside the sphere portal that your devices, it will contain the search results that you input as you open your device and optimize the sufficient technology and ease of access. Provided you just unlock your device and your first red is identification of your tags. And then it's either anchored places you want to go, either something you usually do, or your inquiry, whatever the fuck it is. Identification is there first. And therefore, if we are going to enter a field of information from the outer side and search for the answer from here, by being one of these little spots, that tries to measure and rank and do something useful in this world. That is exactly what's going to happen. Because you are one of these small white dots. The size of it is defined by your output, your activity, your ranks, the goods that you trade against your competitors, the thought forms you clash against, debates. Now, if you are going to look at this one of these small little spots, They will be classified according to the interest and activity that is being used. However, that is exactly what's going to be inside one of these. Inside one of those little spots, little dots, little bubbles, you're going to have your personal identity, a virtualized set of statistics that collect information, tag your interests, tracks the alteration, and enables efficient communication between individuals of the similar interest. And that is also crucial for generating the multi-user thread generator. And multi-user thread generator is extremely crucial in order to generate 3D visual library of assets that will be able to easily be used and developed while you are constructing field of information. It will be used to generate anchor points, locations inside, like this black hole, and inside these locations it would be threads and mastery paths. Mastery path, it will be a chain of locations that will be able to provide virtual rich environment that would facilitate your learning on some matter. I think it lagged a bit, but let's say that this is your personal dimension, your personal space. Your information will be organized, tag based means of organization, and the color is going to help to exploit its potential and hierarchy to organize the layer of either mastery or involvement. So what happens here is that we have a platform and a user. Now it can be anyone, it can be real, it can be a player, it can be whatever it is, depending on the class that you are, because they're going to be sets of different tools that you're going to be using cyber, and over here they're going to be all overlaid. This is multi-purpose thought experiment, therefore we must be as resilient as we can. Regarding search engine, to access search engine identity, or maybe just the chakra representation of it, or the piece of energy that holds light of its own traumatic reflection, is going to interact with the floor under. The floor under is going to open, and light is going to go and turn into the red and access the tag or the search or whatever. The piece of navigation, the various fragments of the mechanism, are going to be pie menus. The pie menus allows quick lock on to the target, opening a pie menu and selecting an option, whatever it is, available, or generating a new option for the others if you are partaking negotiation or discourses. Therefore, the point that you are observing right now, your personal space and your character, is also quantum. The way it works is that on the outer layer, each of the bubbles would represent the identity of the person, and what will be tagged and pinged for the others to see is whatever they're promoting and looking for. Therefore, if you are to interact with one of these points, if you are to click on it, you will observe that visual representation of the identity, and in a manner that you can see those light bulbs over here in exactly the same manner, but more organized. You're gonna encounter the value or the targets, that identity that you have established a link with. I'm not sure. Therefore, the priority of his and your search will be highlighted for the code to be generated. The handwritings were depicted, and I assume that image is kind of best describes it. It is a part of mastery pass. However, what you're going to see here is the point of the data enclosure. However, this particular fragment connects individual with the field of information. Therefore, it's partially relevant right now. As of this image, what you can see is the way that these plans and the traceable curve of volumetric particles along, example of which can be observed in one of these pieces, when piece of volumetric light with a star with a data fragment in it travels through the field of information, it leaves a trace. The faster it is, or the more of them it is, the stronger the trace. If you get it too dense, then you can trace a line. Now this trace will stimulate the, we show the stimulation of data and the flow of traffic, the flow of data. Exactly the same way I want to connect the users and visualize them right here using volumetrics. I'm able to do it, however, on a very primitive scale, and that has to be some adjustments. Therefore, I've done my best to transcribe the vision in a best manner until the point where I can no longer proceed due to fractal divergence. But I'll continue. So each of these points is a user within here. If you're going to activate the platform and look for the search, you're going to dive into the field of information and explore what you seek or encounter and use. Press the one button. I may also seek for others and encounter with members of the community. Now, the way it's going to happen is that there is this core. Inside this core, there is the beginning and the core of the id. Therefore, each one would have its own personal space right there, and its quantum is just there. What is there is the same location as this. However, within it has the trace of the your skills, your abilities, and your entries and your options, because from right from here, right from this core, you are entering field of information, the field of information that we are constructing as a part of our purpose. Therefore, if you are to be a student of this new school system that is visual, and any language can be attached to it, which means any country can do it, and we will fuel our operation by equipping private schools, institutions, especially English learning, with the powerful tools to facilitate the presentation or for the activity lessons, especially in countries like China. But that is for later. This is social network. The reason why this is outward is because the reason. The reason why these bubbles are here is because this is the present. What's on this line is present, what's highlighted is the event, and this event is slowly, slowly fading into the history. And if you can see, they're moving, the big points are moving and slowly, slowly getting back into the core. Which means it's one of the illusions that I attempted to visualize down, since we don't want to move the whole thing, so we might as well leave the data points. I'm aware that they're moving very, very fucking fast. But imagine that each of these is the event. Each of these, this intervention, is an invention of something that has left a mark in history. And that is why it's moving, because time is progressing and the place history is made. Therefore, as a new student, you're going to be progressing from the zero together with the organism. Together with that organism, you're going to progress through the path. As time progressed, which would not only allow you to be connected with the organism of the earth and the planet and know its past, it will also allow you to choose what you want to do further. Therefore, the branching of your profession, which can be one of these black holes, and look at them that way, that would be various progressions and branching and professions that you have to take as if you would be inside. Now, if I'm to dive into it, that is what's going to be. It's a tap, but yeah, you're going to have your personal chamber and around you 360 Skyrim talent progression through the stars kind of tree. Of course, that will be later connected with all the possible systems and the rankings and the statistics that we are tracking. However, I'm gonna need some help with that. I had an image and now it's a part for you to explore. At least now it's possible. But one of these points that you can see around is anchors that would have the label and the mastery, for example, of the lesson that you have left off previous time. Therefore, once you logged in, back in school, kind of online of the education, part-time online, you know, not like proper placement until it's fully ready. But the point is AR integration and using your mobile device as the remote to operate the virtual dimension cyber. And the access point would be obviously the TV of the lecture hall or the any of the smart tables or the HoloLens devices for the future. However, your control would be in your hands for now. Now, each of these points would be the anchors that you are going to be proceeding. They'll be further away from each other. There will be different names, different sizes, different intensity, different progression, and they will be traceable. That means that you will kind of like endless runner as a way to check upon your homework and get quick answers as you cycling through the spectrum, because spectrum is going to be the way that you're going to organize the hierarchy of data by using red as the beginning and purple as the mastery of each of the topics as well. And therefore, enabling you to track, progress, design, and enjoy. Now, what you so far observe is that the same personal dimension targets personal space the head is the three-dimensional social network that represents identity and its virtual statistics that is initially imported by filling the data tables in Excel and converted and attached to the blueprint. How you can organize all that data? It will be a three-dimensional social network, therefore the high value is the target that we seek. Therefore, it will not be for children or not for the business or not for the government. It will be for the humanity to overlay cyber. Therefore, multifunctional. Therefore, making a custom adjustments for each of the classes. Therefore, that flocker can be you. Only or visual representation. What's the difference between jacket or so? But for the sake of it, it's fine. What that meant is that on encountering this user, if you are within the personal space of your mastery pass, where is your inner vault? What you're gonna see, I mean right in there in the middle, what you're gonna see is your reference and progression and your personal statistics that you want to track. For example, your energy resources and your food that you took. However, if you are talking about the outer is the inquiry based. And the inquiry is not tracking. The tracking is in the middle as you go within the system. The outside is for interaction between these data fragments, data clusters that are competing for the survival, for the success, for the visions they carry. And therefore, our main concern would be visions and developing or somehow helping to develop efficient tools to enable visions to be visualized from the inner world of your inner mind to be constructed, virtualized, visualized, and be brought externally to share and to act upon. And that is another implementation of the spectral progression of vision construction from red to purple. EDC. So imagine that these are the events that we seek custom feedback. Right, so for example, we are tracking the observer, right? And you're checking the news, you're watching the world, that is this, and you see the events. Now, these white bigger lights, they are the X macro scale layer of interest, and what they mean is that it is an event that is important, that is large, that requires large feedback or reaction from the portion of the populace that can be advice, help, or so. Now, the spectrum was used here too. For example, the orange color was used to label the research, the purple was used to label the ideas, the genuine ideas that were developed and are to be acted upon by the species, as well as attempt to filter it. The 5 is used to represent the analysis, the 6 is used to resemble the analysis of the present of any matter that is. And the 5th will be referring any matter there is to the already existing knowledge. I already said about the 4th and 3rd as the means to define the strengths and weaknesses. The 3 is value that you can use to sell your hobby or your interest or your value to somebody who needs that value. And of course, the fourth would be used to define you and rank you within others' life. Therefore, warfare is that section. Everything related to money is three. Therefore, if you are to sell your artwork and if you enter the search and filter your search for the artwork, it would be labeled as green because it was written like so. Other colors from this hierarchical spectral exploitation is not really logical and does not resonate with the inner spectral engineering of the spirit. However, they are quite efficient and effective and will be covered later. So each of these small points is the you and our petty little mortal deeds and mischiefs, competition, promotion, races, hangers, and so on. The bigger ones are the events, the delighting, the events that are requiring your attention. Therefore, as the citizen, you will be rewarded for your reaction, and that would be crucial if we are to connect our species. Now, the feed will be passed from various platforms into this one system, and one system will be visualized further. However, it will be not three-dimensional, it will be four-dimensional and panel-based to provide the best experience for navigation. However, it will be semi-dimensional and be using the sphere of interest around individual that can be accessed if I am to dive right into the middle. There will be no pole, but there will be boards and tools for you to generate notes, research, and enhance them. For example, you are to partake into the multiplayer encounter. After entering the search operation and finding your group, the meeting is going to look something like that. And that is the seven individuals, and this is your scientist that knows how the brain works. This is a history teacher, he is the level designer, he is the surgeon, and so forth. Is the purpose of the multi-user thread generator to access the unemployed professionals who will be plenty due to the inability to upkeep and ease of technology will result in large amount of unemployed people, professionals in their fields who are learning and become their masters of their own degrees. Now, what can happen is that this kind of system will be able to assemble a freestyle squad of professionals and now replace every of these black holes with the fragments from the field of information that we are going to be constructing. And the thing about that is that we will be able to not only generate the professional atmosphere that will be able to provide the most efficient learning journey, the path to mastery. And a path to mastery is a chain of locations that you kind of unlock as you go through. You will be able to construct this field of information because for that you have to filter large amounts of data. And filter means you have to organize it on time, along the timeline, reconstruct them, and use external sources as the reference. However, we research it, meaning we have to perform the research and extract the key identification. And the spectrum was used here too, as it is able to unblock any event from red to purple and kind of present any matter it is within the dimensional data table. And therefore, which leaves us the X and Y, and we are able to use raw numbers as the progression of time that will multiply the years and scale the whole organism. And this way, extract the fourth coordinate by tricking. And we will be using the Y coordinate of the data table to inject text and an image and the asset relevant and unwrap those locations within. Now further, the simulation will be developed that will require proper presentation, that will require or stimulate proper interaction of the multiplayer kind of gameplay, like in Lord of the Rings for the local co-op, and having the TV as your common gaze locker and the mobile phone as your device that you control your inventory and your relevant statistics, as well as writing notes or taking notes or assembling notes. And yes, it will be done in the Hogwarts style and just a bit more tech in it. Now the reason for it and for so many effects is because this is primarily to be a tool to facilitate the learning journey of the children, because books and web pages are two-dimensional scenes of past. But my purpose was attempt to assemble these tools together. So far what you saw is that you can see the one-time populous feed of the events that are happening on the outer layer that is used as the shell as to scale the present, and as well as that, record new events and leave them as they come back to past. Because what happens over the shell is future, right? What happens in the middle? Just listen and see, we obviously walk there. And more accurate geolocation, if pleasant. What else is going to be is that the data path is going to be linked and flawed. So when each of the users are going to encounter with each other, or any of the data is going to be traced after each other, you're going to see something like that as a way to connect pieces. ID 1, ID 2, ID 3, and ID 4. You can imagine that this is the same way as the connecticuts discussed in space time. They say the data flow and traces by volumetrics is successful, but the connection and links is pretty much useful there too. But that is not the point. I missed that. You see, each of these points, they can be detached and they can be pointed to the target. For example, the shoulder armor or the sword, and the translation and the meaning and a further spectral analysis of this piece of visual data, that is, while it is being overlapped or interacted or acted upon, is going to unwrap the spectral data that will teach the user, and the spectral hierarchy. This works here too. Now, the spectrum will give it the colors, and the hierarchy from 1 to 7 is what will be the, pretty much the business. I was not able to connect it with the energy centers so far. But in this manner, the pieces of data are going to be connected, and this is just a one point. Now imagine there is a cluster, and this is just like a fourth tier subgroup of having a healthy foods and being fruits, apples, bananas, pears, peaches. Now the other that would lead here is the longer focal line, and there it is spectrophotography. There has to be some sophisticated tools developed for that. I was able to use data tables and extract the third hierarchy, so defining the ID of the previous row as the name to tag and connect accordingly, but it gives kind of fractal structure. Now we have to get this fractal structure into the field of information that is being scaled along time, and that may be a bit tricky. In that way, we will have to trace data in a way of flowing. It will flow straight, right? We start from zero and we go straight and branch as we go along. Therefore, the progression along that curve would not really be fractal. It will be Fibonacci. It will be progressive fracture of events as they come. So is the mind. And so each of these substructures that you can see will most likely have to be fractured by spectrum multiple times in the hierarchy. So hierarchy, fracking, and if you look into the color, colors, yeah, the red that is being first point, they process to the second point, which is orange. Both of them are going to be subfractured into the red, red, orange, red, red, green, red, red, blue. As the third tier substructure. So that is very complicated, and it just branches as it can get all the senses, but it is possible to trace them. And I know it doesn't make any sense at this point for me too, but you have zero, you have one, and every event happened after another. The scale is a trick that we can use to contain it, and if we are zooming with the mouse wheel, we will be able to flip the ears, right? The IDs of the events are identified and clear, and each of these events are visualized as a part for the learning journey and the school that we are to construct. I think I'm going to have it a farewell and do my best to organize and clarify the meaning further until the desired result is extracted. This is too complicated, but it's very fucking fun. I've arrived to the point where visual scripting won't do it, and I assume some heavy scripting is going to be necessary. Therefore, I am to clarify as much as I can and seek for the professionals. I'm looking for your feedback. About this plant here, between the Gandalf and Xavier. She looks good. Yeah, multi-user and multi-player. Same shit. Instead of that, you have a bear that you can dissect and look what's inside his liver, for example. Stats are relevant, but the spectral report is a part. Screenshots done. I'm gonna update my website archives.space. Merry Christmas, Happy New Year. And that is not visible. Peace.